Welcome to Sun City News. I'm your host, Norma Taylor, and here are some of the stories we're covering for you this week. We have some updates from the Community Association. Lily Coleman, Executive Director of Second Helpings, talks about the ways Sun City residents can help in our area. Those stories and more are coming up. Sun City News starts now.
From our studios in Pinckney Hall, this is Sun City News with Norma Taylor. Entertainment news with Randy Selman. Sports with Doug Wright. And the entire Sun City News team covering your community and the South Carolina Lowcountry.
All residents are invited to the next Chat with the Board and GM session at 6 p.m. on Thursday, March 19th at Hidden Cypress. Residents will get a chance to speak with one or more members of the Board of Directors and General Manager Brad Phillips. Then make sure you come out to the Board of Directors quarterly meeting at 2 p.m. on Wednesday, March 25th at Pinckney Hall. All residents are welcome to attend. The Community Association is aware that residents using Chrome browsers may experience difficulties logging into suncityhiltonhead.org. The web development team is working quickly to resolve the situation. So until then, please use another browser such as Firefox, Safari, or Internet Explorer to log into the community website. As spring begins, remember that you might occasionally see alligators moving around the community. Please be aware of your surroundings, especially when walking your pet, and do not feed alligators, as it is illegal and dangerous. Feeding alligators causes them to become aggressive. Now, if you believe there is an aggressive alligator on your property, contact Common Area Maintenance at 843-705-4061. Or security after hours at 843-705-4083. Residents can get a preview of the community's 25th anniversary celebration by visiting the brand new website www.suncity25th.com. The website includes a program guide listing all events for Celebration Week and more. Look out for 25th anniversary emails with more information. For more information about these events and other community activities, check your email inbox for eNews Weekly or log on to suncityhiltonhead.org. Second Helpings is the only agency that rescues food in Beaufort, Jasper, and Hampton counties. Lily Coleman, Executive Director, discusses how Sun City residents are helping in their efforts. Well, Lily, we're always happy to have you join us here on SCTV.
Well, thank you. I'm always happy to be here. We have a lot of volunteers in Sun City.
Yes, I know.
Yes.
Now, what is the mission of Second Helpings, and why is it so important?
Well, Second Helpings rescues food and takes the food to feed to agencies, about 55 agencies, to feed people who need food. But we also are promoting the fact that we prevent food waste, and that's important to our environment. So we rescued almost 3 million pounds of food last year. So that food would have gone into a landfill, but instead it went in to help people eat.
Wow, that is wonderful. Now, what are the challenges that you face in rescuing the food?
Well, we have 340 volunteers, and they're amazing, so we're always looking for more volunteers, so that's one of our challenges. The other challenge is to work with the grocery stores and make sure that we get the food, that they don't throw the food away, that we actually get the food so we can put it on the truck. So that's another big challenge.
340 volunteers and still not enough, right?
Yes, constantly. Yeah, a lot of people like to travel. So, you know, in the summer months especially, if people are willing to volunteer just during the summer months, that would help out a great deal.
So how can our residents volunteer for Second Helpings?
Well, the trucks are out in your parking lot right now. And they're out there all the time if they're not on the road. So call our office and we will get you the information to volunteer. We also need volunteers to plan our annual event, to serve on committees. So those are the, and then we started a new program with Schools, 40% of the lunches are being thrown away. Oh. So we're starting to rescue the food in the schools. So we need to find teams of people that will pick up the rescued food and take it to either an after-school program or an elderly program. We're trying to supplement their needs there.
Wow. I didn't know that about the schools.
That's new.
How can people advocate for this excellent, excellent cause?
Well, I think to understand that you have to give locally. I mean, if you give to a national organization, being a feeding or hunger organization, none of that money stays in this community. So it's important that when you donate money, either at the grocery store or anywhere, that you ask if the funds are staying locally. We have a policy, we will loan out our trucks. We loan them out when there's a hurricane warning or a tropical storm. We also help at Hudson's Community Dinner. We loan out a truck. So we will get our trucks involved. In fact, I think they will be involved with the postal drive this May. We're partnering with Bluffton Self-Help to pick up a lot of those perishables, non-perishable items. So it's important that they advocate for us and that they realize that money should stay locally. And that anytime you've got leftover food, like right now we've got this crisis with this virus, people are buying all kinds of stuff. And then after it's over, then they have all this sanitizers and masks. Give it to us. We could use them on the truck. So be sure to think about that when you're ready to donate those items. Don't let them sit there. And then after hurricane, we all stock up. So if you have to give extra food, give us a call. We'll come and pick it up.
Okay, excellent points that you bring. Thank you, Lily, for coming on the show and talking about this very worthy cause.
Thank you so much. We appreciate it.
When we come back, Lindsay Blackman from Lifestyle Services tells us about upcoming lifestyle events. Reporter Chris Chase checks out the Irish Heritage Club. And Courtney Guthrie updates us on scuba. So don't go away. We'll be right back after these important messages. Lindsay Blackman is here to remind us of the variety and multitude of events Lifestyle Services offer Sun City residents.
Spring is in the air. That means some warmer weather, so make sure you join us for some great outdoor activities we have planned. Join us on March 26, Country Music Night. Tickets are going to be $28, and that includes a great buffet dinner. Tickets are available online and at Lifestyle Services. Also coming up, back by popular demand, Target the Band will be joining for our Music in the Square, formerly known as the Block Party. This will be taking place April 25th at 7 p.m. Tickets are $8 and available at Lifestyle Services or online. We look forward to seeing you out there.
Have you wondered what is in those cases in Pinckney Hall? Mary Gallagher told Chris Chase, the Blarney, the folklore of the Irish Heritage Society. Then they entered the wonderful rehearsal of the Irish dance.
You've probably walked by this case many times at Pinckney Hall, but you know the significance of the things in here. Mary Gallagher, the president of the Irish Heritage Society, is going to tell us.
Good morning. Irish culture is really wonderful. We have so many things besides parades and dancing, and we'd like to show off some of our culture. A big symbol that a lot of people know is the cladda. The cladda is heart, hands, and crown. The heart is for love, the hands are for friendship, and the crown is for loyalty. Many people use this as a wedding ring also, and all cultures, really. I've seen plenty of people that are not Irish who just love that symbol. Of course, everybody knows about the Irish dancers. That is probably our most visible display of Irish culture at this time of the year. But this is a bodhran. This is an Irish drum, and it usually is made out of animal skin. And I believe this is one that is made out of goat skin. And it's really used in ceremonial events. And we've been working very hard all year. And of course, our big event is March 21st, which is the St. Patrick's Day party here in Pinckney Hall.
You know what, Mary? This sounds like you got a lot of things going on. And thanks so much for showing us the case. Speaking of the dancers, let's go look at them.
Very good. They're all assembling right now.
Four, five, six, everybody left.
Now, Rosemary, it must be a lot of fun, too, teaching a class like this.
It is a lot of fun, and that's our main focus. We're keeping the tradition alive by learning Irish country dancing, but our focus is on fun and friendship. And when they make a mistake, they just giggle.
Now, to join this group, because I was looking at it, it looks like fun. Do you have to have any prior experience?
No prior experience. There's a couple of basic steps, and I will teach those in the beginning. I also do some kind of a little warm-up every week so that we can go over that. And a lot of times, new people that come the first time are in there dancing with them. Our dancers are really nice. They pull everybody along. They let you have a good time. They want to make friends with you. So it is it's a fun group.
I was just saying, it really looks like everybody was having a lot of fun. Well, keep it going.
Thank you.
This is Chris Chase for Sun City TV.
Reporter Courtney Guthrie follows the Scuba Club as it combines skills and enjoyment underwater.
Hi, I'm in front of the Scuba Shack where I'm going to take my very first scuba diving lesson. This is in conjunction with the Sun City Scuba Diving and Snorkeling Club, which you're welcome to join, and we told you about just a few weeks ago. So if you're up to learning a whole new sport, guys, I'm with you. Wish me luck. I'm here with Rob Lanoux, and he's going to instruct me today on my very first introduction to scuba diving. Tell me a little bit about how I would sign up if I was interested in getting into scuba diving.
There's a couple different ways to do it. I mean, if you are hard set and ready to go do it, you basically go to our website, you pick a date, you hit that date, sign up, we get back in touch with you. You got a choice of doing e-learning or book learning. E-learning is the new wave of today that you eliminate some of the time you have to spend at the store, and you actually get more time in the pool. So in the long haul, it is actually a better way to learn how to scuba dive. To become a better diver, you have to dive. So,
all right. And tell me a little bit about, as someone who's living in an older community, what the experience of scuba diving can do to improve your health.
You get out there and you get to see the world, you get to see the pretty. It's not an Olympic sport, but it is physically demanding in somewhat. It motivates you to get back in shape. You go to places like Bonaire where you walk in off the beach and it's some of the prettiest diving in the world. So there's a little bit of physical exercise involved.
And what exactly am I going to be doing today?
Today you're going to do what's called Discover Scuba, where we're going to put you in the water. We're going to show you a couple skills, and we're going to take you under the water, sort of try it before you buy it. Scuba diving is probably the coolest thing that you'll ever do in your life, short of going to the moon, and not all of us get to go to the moon.
Well, that's it for me. I've had a great time, and I highly suggest all of my friends and family out there in Sun City to try this. I'm Courtney Guthrie for Sun City News.
Still much more to come on Sun City News. Randy Selman reports on upcoming events in her entertainment report. Reporter Chris Chase talks to Joe Rooney of the Lowcountry Civil War Roundtable. Doug Wright has a women's softball update and other sports news. We'll return after some messages from our sponsors. Well, it's time for some entertainment news. Well, Randy, I hear there's a lot of singing and dancing happening here in Sun City.
Right you are, Norma. Magnolia Hall, Pickney Hall, and the Pavilion. I'm sure everyone will have a swinging time. Man of La Mancha opens on Friday, March 20th. Eileen Waite has directed a stellar cast of characters in this iconic musical that follows the antics of Don Quixote and those he meets in a Spanish dungeon during the Spanish Inquisition. So don't just dream the impossible dream. Go see it live on the Magnolia Hall stage. Country Music Night is back at the Pavilion on Thursday, March 26th. Grab your cowboy or cowgirl hat, pull on your jeans and boots, and get ready to dance the night away. Country artists Lee Bryce and Cole Swindle will entertain you as you enjoy a delicious buffet dinner with your friends.
Tickets are going fast, so grab yours at Lifestyle Services or online. If you haven't had your fill of dancing at Country Music Night, head over to Pinckney Hall on March 31st, where the company band will be playing a blend of Motown, R&B, pop, current hits, dance classic, oldies, beach music, and jazz. This Charleston band features horns, vocals, and a killer rhythm section. This is one band that will leave you wanting more. Pick up your tickets now. I'm Randy Selman, and that's your entertainment report. Remember, life is entertaining, so don't miss the show.
Round Table, but not Camelot. Chris Chase found out the real story on what goes on at the Round Table meetings from Joe Rooney.
Here in the Low Country, we have fantastic history here, and we're here with the Roundtable Civil War, Joe, to hear more about it. So, Joe, tell us about the Civil War.
Well, here in Beaufort County is where the Civil War really starts, and we have a Low Country Civil War Roundtable celebrating our 20th anniversary. So that will be April 30th, right here in Magnolia Hall. We are going to have two of the top history professors in Beaufort County. Dr. Larry Rowland, who is professor of history at USCB Emeritus, who wrote a 3-volume books on the history of Beaufort County.
Very knowledgeable.
He is. And we also have the second best historian, Dr. Stephen Weiss. He's head of the museum at Parris Island and has all of the military history of the Civil War here in Beaufort County. So we will both have Dr. Larry Rowland and Dr. Stephen Weiss here on April 30th. And they're going to show us all of the highlights of what happened here from 1861, November 7, when the First Army of the North comes to Beaufort County.
Well, it's time for sports. And Doug, there seems to be a lot of action on the sports scene. So what's on tap?
Well, I'll tell you, there's some Guinness and there's some Yingling, maybe some you mean in softball, golf, and pickleball. Well, let's get to it. The women's spring softball season kicked off on March 8th with 4 teams competing for a pennant. In addition, the women's traveling team, the Islanders, is gearing up for a busy summer of competition. We spoke to Victoria Black and Dennis McGuire about these programs and our talented group of women's softball players. Well, welcome back, Dennis and Victoria.
Great to be back.
Thank you for coming.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Now, Dennis, you're involved not only with the Women's League, but also the traveling team. Tell us about the Women's League first that just started up.
Okay, we just started up Sunday. We had our opening day event for the second season. And we now turn over to Wednesdays. We had a second game this past Wednesday, and we'll be having right through the end of April, every Wednesday from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m., 2 games.
Sounds great. Victoria, you play in that league, of course, but you're also on the traveling team called the
Islanders, Sun City Islanders.
And tell us about what's going on there in your scheduling.
Well, in our scheduling right now, we have we have May 8th, where we're heading out to the Columbia, South Carolina, for the state games, the senior Suns South Carolina state games. And if we win, place, or show in that tournament, mm-hmm. we'll be qualified for the 2021 Nationals in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. So that's May the 8th. And then May 12th and 13th, Peachtree's coming here. That's more of a league event. But Peachtree from Sun City is coming here to Sun City Hilton Head.
They're just bringing one team.
They're bringing one team, and we have about 3 to throw at them.
Ah, good.
So it'll be fun.
Several other events are on tap in the coming weeks, including a women's 9-hole golf tournament on March 30th, the Low Country Pickleball Classic on April 3rd through 5th, and the Neighborhood Golf Challenge on April 4th. Put these events on your calendar and keep that body in motion. Doug Wright, Sun City Sports.
Although St. Patrick's Day honors the patron saint of Ireland, the largest celebrations are in the United States. Originally a sedate religious holiday, the St. Patrick's Day we know today was reinvented by Irish immigrants as a way to celebrate their heritage. Savannah, Georgia only has a population of 150,000, yet it has the second largest St. Patrick's Day parade behind New York City. Savannah began its march towards St. Patrick's Day fame in 1814, when the oldest Irish society in America, the Hibernia Society, organized a procession to the town's independent Presbyterian church. Today, the total number of marchers, revelers, and visitors has grown to more than 350,000, more than double the population of the entire city. Here's some fun facts of Ireland. 1. Newgrain Passage in County Meath is 800 years older than the Giza Pyramid and 1,000 years older than Stonehenge. Newgrain is best known for the illumination of its passage and chamber by the winter solstice sun. Above the entrance to the passage of the mound, there is an opening called a roof box. On mornings around the winter solstice, a beam of light penetrates the roof box and travels up the 19-meter, which is 62 1/3 feet, passage and into the chamber. As the sun rises higher, the beam widens so that the whole chamber is dramatically illuminated. 2. The first St. Patrick's Day celebration in the United States was held in Boston in 1737. 3. The color of St. Patrick's Day was originally blue. Who knew? Wearing green has become a staple of St. Patrick's Day. 4. Legend says that each leaf of the clover has a meaning: hope, faith, love, and luck. 5. Your odds of finding a four-leaf clover are about 1 in 10,000. 6. Guinness is one of the most popular drinks on St. Patrick's Day. 7. There are 34.7 million U.S. residents with Irish ancestry. This number is more than 7 times the population of Ireland. 8. St. Patrick was never canonized by a pope, making his saintly status somewhat questionable. But 'tis a grand man nonetheless. And here's the traditional blessing. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the hollow of his hand. What a great way to end the show. Thanks for watching. We invite you to check out Sun City TV's weekly program schedule in Sensations Magazine. And now check highlights and alerts on Twitter at SunCityTVHHI. Also email us at suncitytvhh@gmail.com. Now to see extended coverage of your favorite news segments, tune in to Extra. Check the current Sensations magazine for daily times. Make sure you tune in next week to find out all the news that's happening in our community. In the meantime, I hope your week is full of only good news. For Sun City News, I'm Norma Taylor. And I'll see you next week.